Yeah.
Oh, okay, so maybe some were curious. They know those pictures. So maybe press the right mouse button here and look. Oh my god, I cannot read this.
Yes. That must be... Which one?
This one? Are you sure?
I'm not sure.
Okay, you can try. Yeah, but it should be for both monitors. Yeah, set it and now press or this one, I don't know.
I haven't changed anything.
Yes, but because we have to apply it. Press some kind of button, yeah. That's how it does.
No, it's still the same.
It's too much.
Let's see the slides.
Okay, this is it. Okay, so you have your group there, okay?
Okay. Hello, my name is Vladimir Ilistratov. I have an honor to be the last one today. My talk is titled Procitectura, a procedural approach to create architectural 3D models. All the stuff I'm going to talk about can be found on this GitHub repo, including the source code of the add-on and the tutorial. So, what is Procitectura? There is a version that it has a Greek origin, like this. It means programmable or procedural architecture. So how does it work? Let's pick up a building footprint and pick up a set of Python functions and produce a 3D architecture model. And let's go ahead and see it in Blender. So we set a set of Python functions here. We selected a building footprint and now pressing apply Procitectura rule. So it must be textured. Yeah, like this. And we can play with some parameters like changing a height a bit. Or changing floor height. That's too much probably. And so on. It's possible also to change colors. Let's use yellow instead of boring gray one. So like this. So a few basic facts about Procitectura. A set of small Python functions is used to generate a 3D model of buildings. Those Python functions are called rules. Each subsequent rule refines the model and adds additional details. And Procitectura was inspired by CGI shape grammar developed in the Swiss Federal Institute of Technology in Zurich, and currently is used by software S3 City Engine. Has anyone heard of S3 City Engine? Yeah, okay. So that's work in progress, and the goal is to be able to code the most of existing and ever existed buildings with Procitectura. So let's consider an example rule set. We start from import, so PRO is short for Procitectura. Then we define some parameters. We've seen these parameters in the example I showed you just a few seconds before. It's height, floor height, and so on. And notice that we use here a function param. If a parameter is wrapped in this function, it means that this parameter could be accessed from outside and changed indirectly as I showed you just a minute ago. Also notice that height is generated randomly between 20 and 40. And roof color is not a parameter that accessed from outside. It can be accessed from outside. It's just a normal Python variable. So let's continue. Well, Let's start from building footprint. And the first rule is normally called a lot. We perform an extrude to the specified height. And the execution is passed to the next rule called building. So let's examine the next rule called building. And here we perform decomposition. A front face will be processed by a front facade rule. A side face, in fact, a number of side faces will be processed by side facade rule. And the top face will be processed by the roof rule. So next, consider front facade and side facade rules. Here we apply a texture. We specify a path to the texture and its width and height in the global coordinates or in the real world coordinates. So one can say that this texture is 50 centimeters width and 50 centimeters height in the real world coordinates. And this texture will be inherited by all child rules, unless overridden by another texture or material. Then we perform a split in their vertical direction. So we cut a ground floor. It will be processed by the ground floor rule. And we cut a number of, we perform a number of repetitive splits. That's why we have here a repeat function. And each cut will be processed by the floor rule. But what is the size of the each cut? Is it a floor height? Not really. We have here a FLT function. It means floating size. So in this context, repeat and FLT combination means cut the remaining space for the whole number of cuts. Yeah. So the total number of floors will be a whole number, not like 2.4 like this. Yeah. It will be the whole one. Yeah. So on the side facade used for side faces, it looks nearly the same, but instead I apply here a boring gray color instead of the texture. So let's continue. Next we process the ground floor, and therefore we have the ground floor rule. We override the texture with another texture. We specify the path again, and we specify its size in the global coordinates. And then we perform a split, and this time the split is performed in the horizontal direction. So we would like to have some margin on the left and on the right. And this margin will be processed by sidewall function. Then we like to have an entrance on the right. And the entrance has a floating size. Therefore, we have a FLT function. And the entrance will be processed by entrance style rule. And we cut the rest, and again, we have here repetitive cuts. And they will be used for windows and processed in the tile rule. So next, we cut the entrance door and the windows. So let's consider the tile rule. So here we perform a split again in the horizontal direction. Our window will have the width of 2. And the remaining space will be just preserved for the wall. We have here no rule specified, and all materials, all textures from the parent rules will be inherited for this case. So then we cut some, then we process this rectangle used for the rule, used for the window, and the bottom, we cut it again, and this time in the horizontal direction. The bottom part, we cut the bottom part, then cut a window. The window has a height of 1.5. It will be processed by the window rule, and the rest, we have here no rule. and the all and this piece will inherit all materials and all textures from the parent rules. And the entrance style used for the entrance door is nearly similar. We cut here a door. So let's go ahead. And these rules are quite small, and here we just assign a texture. But notice that for the door and for the windows, we don't assign a size. It means in this context that the texture will occupy all available space. And here we substitute the texture with another texture and specify the size for it. So here is how it looks like. And interesting feature that the same rule could be applied to an arbitrary building footprint. And this leads us immediately to an interesting application, that's city generation. We have a city, a set of building footprints for a city or a part of a city. And we apply for each footprint the same or specific set of rules. So, and generate a city. So let's take a look at the demo I have prepared. So it takes a while. Here, here's our city. Let's see it rendered. Let's go back to our presentation. So another interesting application is, so what could we do with this city? I attempted to bring it to the web. And so I placed the city in a WebGL virtual globe provided by Cesium JavaScript library. So for that I had to perform the conversion from Blender to Collada and then to GLTF format. So GLTF format is an emergent format specifically designed for WebGL applications. It's developed by the same organization that recently developed Collada format. So Ton mentioned in his keynote speech that WebGL viewer or player is important for Blender, and I think direct exporter and importer to and from GLTF is also quite important, as WebGL is getting in momentum. So I will not show the demo, because if both Blender and web browser are open, they're slowed down. So, and let's go back to our city demo. So it looks like a relatively detailed model. You see here we have each window and each entrance door card in the building. So what about baking? So this city model could be used in interactive applications, be it a WebGL application or a game. I realized the baking in the following way. So one supplies a rule set for the high poly model, and one supplies a rule set for a low poly model. In this case, it's just an extrusion, just extruded footprint. And then the texture baking is performed. So let's see how it works. I specified high poly rule set and low poly rule set and place and press bake button. Well, it takes a while. Yeah. So let's see how it looks like. I think it's quite easy to see that it's low quality texture. And let's see the back texture. Is our back texture. So the output of baking, texture baking. So another interesting application is parametric modeling. I already talked about it a bit. So we specify some parameters and we use a function param to say that this parameter should be accessible from outside and changed interactively. So I code it a model from a real world model. It exists in the reality. Let's see it. Okay. So this building exists in the reality. I tried to coordinate it with 26 parameters. So let's play a bit with them. Let's change something. Like height. It's too much. And so on. Yeah. I think the idea is clear. So the set of parameters could be quite arbitrary and so interesting. And one could tweak a model as he or she desires. That's our model. However, it doesn't perform, it doesn't work stably. So it crashes from time to time. I have to find out what's the reason of the crash. So that's basically what I have realized so far. Now I would like to talk about work for the current weeks or month. So what about the roofs? You probably remember that the top face of our example should be processed by the roof rule. But I actually didn't show you anything about the roof because it hasn't realized so far. For that, we have to specify, to find a good specification for a roof function, and then we have to implement it. Well, I can propose a specification for the roof function only for simple cases, and for complex cases it should be, we'll have to think more about how to specify it. Let's say we have a hipped roof, and we have a height, so it could be specified in this simple way. And the same for a gabled roof. However, it's not often that roofs are that simple. We often have very complex roof shapes, and a good specification should be found for those cases. And about a few words about implementation, there is an algorithm called straight skeleton used to solve roofs, and it's already developed in the inset polygon provided by Howard Tricky. So it would be a good starting point. However, it doesn't work in every case. Let's consider an example. Yeah, that's simple footprint. However, it's not that simple for the straight skeleton algorithm. So I press insert polygon. Let's add some height here and see what's going on. Simple footprint, however, this case is not that simple for the add-on. It should be investigated how to fix it, and so it can be used for architectura. Another direction of work could be simplification of architectural function. Currently, I have that complex structure. Decompose, then parentheses, then dot, then into. It's related to the fact how Python processes, how the Python works. However, I think it's possible to do it like this, in simple way. It requires some digging into Python machinery, however, without going to Python source code. And the same for split function. We have here into, it could be simplified like this. So I'm close to finish. How could you contribute? Try to code a building with architecture and give your feedback. Help to specify and implement a roof, window, door, balcony, stairs, and so on functions. Help to specify and implement different facade decoration functions. And so thank you for your attention. Everything could be found on this GitHub repo, including the source code for the add-on and a tutorial. And also there is a thread in blendartist.org. Okay, thank you.
People have questions, they can come down. We will close the day session now. People can have a drink or go out or have dinners. There are two screenings of the Susanna Festival, one at 7 and one at 9:30. There will be the same screening, so simply pick one of them. You can go out now first and have food, come back at 9:30, or stay here a bit and watch it at 7. So thank you, and I'll see you later.
I have a question regarding your presentation. When you do the whole file, the whole CD, is it possible to then change randomly some parameters so that not all the buildings become equal?
Well, just specify which parameters you want to be random.
Mm-hmm. Like, for instance, the height.
Yeah.
Okay. So you can then change, even if you grow the whole building, the whole...